casting procedures. Dr. Shenoy madam has already taken casting procedures, but a little bit of overview we can discuss about the casting again. What are the definition madam has covered? The screw former is a plastic, is the wax plastic or the metal pattern used to form the channel, that is called as a screw former. Investing is the process of covering or enveloping the wax pattern with a suitable investment material before casting. The wax pattern can be fabricated either direct or indirect technique, and that particular, then the next step would be attaching the screw former and reservoir to the wax pattern. So something is to be mentioned, like diameter of the screw former should be same or slightly more as the thickest portion of the wax pattern. Then the length of the screw former should be 6 mm for the gypsum and 3 to 4 mm for the phosphate bonded investment material. Reservoir should always be there, and that prevents the localized shrinkage porosity. Here you can see the wax pattern of a single particular crown and the wax pattern of a 3 unit fixed partial denture. Here the, it is the reservoir and this is the screw former. Here these are the reservoir and this is the screw former, this is the crucible former. The casting procedure, next step would be the investment, investing procedure. For investing, Dr. Kishore Mahalla has explained the investing procedure and the material properly. We need to have either gypsum bonded, phosphate bonded or ethyl silicate bonded kind of a material that can be mixed either manual mixing or the vacuum mixing. Obviously, vacuum mixing will have a good superior kind of a physical properties of that particular mix. So, if the provision is there, we should always follow the vacuum mixing because it's more standardized. Now the investing procedure, this is the ring liner, this is the ring, and this is the wax pattern. We are supposed to keep the investing like this. The next step would be the burnout, where the investing ring is placed in the room temperature furnace and it is heated up to 500 degrees Celsius if we want to have a hygroscopic kind of an expansion. If we need a thermal expansion in case of a gypsum bonded, it is to be heated till 650 degrees Celsius or 700 degrees Celsius. In case of a phosphate bonded investment material, which is a combination of regular expansion and thermal expansion, we should go always for a 800 degrees Celsius for the burnout of phosphate bonded investment material. Whenever the mold, we have a cross section of the mold cavity after burnout, we should always be able to see the crucible former, screw former, wax pattern, ring liner, casting ring. Now here again, the top portion of the wax pattern should be at least 6 mm below the casting ring. And the down portion of that particular wax pattern should have minimum of 6 millimeters of a screw former, that is the utmost requirement that should be followed while the screw making. The next one would be the casting, actual casting procedure. The actual casting procedure can be done either by centrifugal casting machine or by induction casting machine. In the centrifugal casting machine, the torch flame is and the glazed ceramic crucible is used, where the metal pellets are going to heated by a oxyacetylene kind of a flame. And on that oxyacetylene kind of a flame, with the help of a torch, that metal will be going to mold, melted, and that particular, after melting of that metal, the machine is released, and that will lead to the rotation in a very high specific, and the, with the help of centrifugal force, that material is, molten metal is forcefully injected in the mold cavity by a centripetal force. So what we studied in the physics of the 8th standard, like the centripetal and the centrifugal force, it is a basic physics what we have, the centrifugal casting machine works upon. So the casting procedure done by induction casting machine, in this the metal is melted by an induction field to develop the crucible surrounded by water cooled metal tubing, where the air pressure is used to force the metal in the mold. Sometimes the vacuum or without the vacuum it can be used. Mostly it is used for base metal alloys. This is the induction casting machine. Where the this is the crucible where the metals are placed, and the heat is activated through the induction system. Casting defects. Casting defects are basically classified on the basis of distortion, surface roughness, irregularity, porosity, incomplete casting, and contamination. What is distortion? Distortion is any marked distortion of the casting is probably related to the distortion of the wax pattern. So there can be either change in shape or size can happen, or both may cause misfit. Both may cause misfit, like in case of required size and shape is somewhat like this. The change in shape can occur in like this. If this is the change in size and this is the change in shape, what we can see in case of a distortion happened by a in the casting defect. Then how to, what are the different causes for the casting? The causes for the distortion is careless removal from the die. When the pattern is carelessly removed from the die, or too much of the vibration is used during investing of the material. If the investment material is too thick while pouring, delay in the investment. If the wax pattern is fabricated and that particular wax pattern is kept as it is in the atmosphere and then it is placed after 8 to 10 hours, there would be a release of internal stresses by the wax and there would be a distortion in the wax pattern. Inhomogeneous setting and thermal expansion of the material, that is the investment material. Then increase as the thickness of the pattern decreases. The distortion always increases as the thickness of the pattern decreases. So if the you have a very least kind of a thickness of a pattern, you should be very cautious that there are chances for the distortion of The less the setting expansion of the investment, less the distortion of the casting can be there. How will you prevent? The manipulation of waxes to be done at a high temperature. The investing wax pattern within 1 hour after the fabrication, that is after the finishing of the wax pattern. If the storage of that particular wax pattern is important and necessary, then it is to be stored in a refrigerator so that it should not release the stresses. Leaving about 3 millimeter of the gap for the ring liner at the end, and that restrict the expansion so you can avoid or minimize distortion. What are surface roughness and irregularity? This is the question which is asked to the student most of the time, because the student doesn't know what is the difference between surface roughness and the surface irregularity. The basic difference of the surface roughness and irregularity is this. The surface roughness is evenly distributed, fine roughness is there, whereas in case of irregularity, it is a isolated imperfections would be there. What are the causes? Incorporation of air bubble during and after the investment procedure. If their air bubbles are incorporated during or after the investment procedure, the chances for surface irregularity is there. How will you prevent it? The prevention can be done by the proper mixing of the investment material, vibration of the mix, and by vacuum investing. The surface roughness, again the cause is water film may be present on the surface of the wax pattern, or there is the too high water powder ratio for the investment material. What are the cause prevention? Use the wetting agent or the surfactant. The soap solution is the best surfactant or the wetting agent that can be used to reduce the surface tension of the wax so that the investment material will be properly adapted to that wax pattern, and proper water powder ratio should be used for the investing procedures. Again, what is the cause? There is a too rapid heating. The flaking of the investment can happen. So, ideally, gradually, we are supposed to increase the temperature of the mold from room temperature to 700 degrees Celsius in a burnout furnace in 1 hour, not less than that. Surface roughness and irregularity, what are the causes? Like water powder ratio, if the water powder ratio is high, casting would be rough. Or if the water powder ratio is less, there would be a thick investment and cannot be properly applied to the wax pattern. How will you prevent? Use the correct ratio as per the manufacturer's recommendation. Either the too high or the too low kind of a casting pressure is done, then you can have surface roughness or surface irregularity. So ideally, you are supposed to use 15 pounds per square inch air pressure for induction casting machine, or minimum of 3 to 4 for centrifugal casting machine, that you are supposed to know. Next is porosity. Porosity is classified as those caused by the solidification defect. It is either localized shrinkage porosity, suck back porosity, or microporosity. Those caused by the trapped air is either gas inclusion porosity, pinhole porosity, or subsurface porosity. Or those enclosed by the residual air in the mold is back pressure porosity. So, the casting porosity, whenever we discuss about the localized shrinkage porosity, it is a large irregular void which is close to the sprue attachment. You can see which is close to the sprue attachment, and it is as the bulkiest part. It is caused by the premature termination of the flow of molten metal during solidification. And as the molten alloy continues solidification from the cooler mold wall, if the sprue is blocked by a pre-solidification thing, then there would be a deficiency of molten metal at the bulkiest part and localized shrinkage porosity occurs. The next is, how will you prevent it? Prevention is very easy. You are supposed to attach the sprue which is thickest portion of the wax pattern. Again, MCQ can be asked to you regarding this particular point, like localized shrinkage porosity can be minimized by the sprue of the thickness more than the thickest portion of the pattern. Always flaring of the sprue at the point of attachment is important. And the use of reservoir is also recommended. Next is setback porosity. It is a variation of shrink spot porosity. External, it is external void usually seen inside the crown opposite to the sprue. What are the causes? If the temperature of the molten metal entering the mold is very high, it raises the temperature of the mold opposite to the sprue, because opposite to the sprue is the site where the first point of contact of the hot molten metal would be there. Due to this particular hot spot, molten alloy solidification is near it. The molten metal is sucked back by solidifying the metal against it, and the solidification shrinkage occurs localized to the near hotspot. So this is the setback porosity, where you can see here is the sprue, and opposite to the sprue here the setback porosity is seen. This is the correct sequence for the cooling down of metal. Like the peripheries are to be cooled first, and then the it is to be, the sprue former should be cooled. It is the correct sequence. Whereas in case of setback porosity, where the sprues are not properly given, the particular portion against the sprue would be first heated, and there would be a solidification in the sprue area. So the setback porosity occurs. How will you prevent it? Flaring the point of a sprue attachment is the preventive method, and reducing the temperature difference between the mold and the molten alloy. Means if there is a gross difference of the mold temperature and the molten alloy, you have a chance to develop a setback porosity. It should be in the range of around 30 to 40 degrees Celsius, so there would not be any kind of setback porosity. What are microporosities? Microporosities are the small irregular voids throughout the casting. Again, the word throughout the casting is very important. It reduces the strength and affects the physical properties of particular metal. How it is causes? It is causes due to solidification shrinkage, premature solidification, and undue solidification of the metal. The temperature of the molten metal entering the mold is low, and it's close to its solidification temperature. But how will you prevent it? The temperature of the casting alloy should be high as compared to the molten metal. What would be the cause of pinhole porosity? The absorbed gases are released throughout the particular casting, or as a very small spherical pinholes, which produces voids due to simultaneous solidification. On solidification, these absorbed gases are expelled and the pinhole porosity results. How will you prevent it? The molten alloy should not be kept for a long time before the casting, so that it should not incorporate more amount of gases. What is gas inclusion porosity? Is the spherical void, but are the larger than pinhole porosity. What are the causes? Cause is the same. The mechanical trapping of the molten metal or included during the rapid flow of molten metal into the mold by a turbulent motion. How will you prevent it? The high speed of the casting, the rotation of the centrifugal casting machine or the induction casting machine is to be monitored properly. What do you understand by subsurface porosity? The subsurface porosity is caused by a simultaneous nucleation of solid grains and the gas bubble at the first moment that the alloy freezes at the mold walls. How will you prevent? By controlling the rate at which the molten metal enters into the mold. The back pressure pin porosity, back pressure porosity, and setback porosities are the two porosities that are to be studied properly, because most of the time the examiners ask you the question either in the viva or in your theory examination. So the how the back pressure porosity happens when the molten alloy enters the mold, the air trapped in the mold is compressed at the extremities and that exerts some amount of back pressure that prevents the molten alloy to occupy the complete region of the mold. And if there is an inadequate porosity or inadequate venting of the investment material is there, the back pressure porosity occurs. If there is a proper ventilation of that particular porosity of the investment material is proper, then there would be a proper ventilation of air from that particular pocket to the outer side. And if that is not there, then there are chances for the back pressure porosity. You can see here the back pressure porosities are occurred due to accumulation of the air which is compressed in that particular extremity, and that exerted the back pressure that has not allowed the molten metal to cover the entire area. How will you prevent it? The prevention is the investment of an adequate porosity, means it should have a proper venting, and the pattern should not have the 6 millimeter away from the end of the rings that we already discussed. If the whatever the rules of the casting are properly followed, the chances for back pressure porosities are relatively less. Then the incomplete casting, due to incomplete amount of molten metal entering the mold, if the quantity of the molten metal is less, the chances for incomplete casting would be there. If the insufficient amount of alloy for the melting is relatively less, then there are chances for incomplete casting is there. Alloy is not sufficiently molten, means if it is highly viscous, then again there would be an incomplete casting because it will not flow properly. Then alloy not able to enter the thin parts of the mold. If there are thin parts within the mold, the chances are there that it will not enter the mold. Again, the premature solidification of the alloy, then the low casting pressure. If the properly form, if the properly rules of that particular thing is casting is followed, then the chances for incomplete casting would be relatively less. Contamination is the last kind of thing which is to be discussed while discussing casting defects, and causes are due to oxidation of the molten metal when it is overheated. That is the use of oxidizing zone. Always you are supposed to use the reducing zone of a flame in a centrifugal casting machine. If any time by mistake oxidizing zone is used for the molting, for the melting of the molten alloy, then there are chances for contamination of the casting would be there. Then how will you prevent it? You are not supposed to overheat the alloy. Use the proper zone, that is the reducing.